the lucky guy. I'm like gonna cry. I got tears coming out of my nose. Mad props, he's the campus catch. You're a perfect match, cause you both have such great taste in clothes. Of course he will propose. Dear El Honey Mazel Tov, future's taking off. Bring that ring back and show it to me. 4 carats of Princess Khan. Are you psyched or what? I just wish I could be this. When he gets down on one knee. Oh my god, you guys. Looks like Elle's gonna win the prize. If there ever was a perfect couple, this one qualifies. Oh my god, you guys. Oh my god, this is happening. Our own homecoming queen and king. Finally she'll be trying on a huge engagement ring for size. Oh my god, you guys. Oh my god.
Shut up, Elle. Shut up, Warner. Shut up, engage. Oh my god.
Okay, everybody sign. Good, now fall in line. And we'll start the engagement parade. Light candles, single file. Don't forget to smile. Who's the cupcake? Who's back to me?
Sorry.
Not prepared to serenade.
Oh my god, you guys. Looks like Al's gonna win the prize.
If there ever was a perfect couple,
this one.
Delta knew, soon to be fiancé. Now that a man chose you, your life begins today. Make him a happy home. Waste not his hard-earned wage. And so he does not roam. Strive not to look your age. Still in your hour of need, let it be understood. No man can supersede our sacred bond of sisterhood.
Oh my god, you guys.
just perfect.
No, you're perfect.
No, you are.
No, you are.
No, you.
No, you.
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 You. Okay, now I'm even irritating myself.
Elle, I just want you to know how happy you've made me. Every guy dreams about finding a girl that looks like you. Both know why we're here. I see it in your eyes. I guess it calms my fears to know it's not a surprise. I thought one look at you, looking like a dream come true, would leave me speechless like you always do. But now we're wide awake, and we've got some plans to make. Let's take some action, baby. So baby, give me your hand. I've got some dreams to make true. I've got the future all planned. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with you. Honey, I'm not finished.
Oh, sorry.
Since I was 2 or 3, my life was planned out neat. I'd get my law degree,
yeah,
and then win my Senate seat. A big white house back east, all the amenities,
yeah.
3 kids at least, just like the Kennedys. Here's where our lives
begin.
But just where do you fit in? I'll break it down now, baby.
Oh,
so baby, give me your hand.
Here's my hand.
I've got some dreams to make true.
We both have dreams to make true.
I know that you'll understand.
Oh, yes, I understand.
It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with serious.
Coming
up to take our journey. Serious. I'll tell you as future attorney. Then take, don't be shy.
Okay.
Maybe that's why you and I,
you and I
should break up.
Yeah, maybe I'll give you my hand. Wait, what?
You're breaking up with me? But I thought you were proposing.
Oh, well, I did talk to my parents about it, Pooh Bear, but they expect a lot
of...
Expect a lot from me. I'm going to Harvard Law School, and my brother's at Yale Law, and so's his new wife, and she's a Vanderbilt, for Christ's sake.
What, so I'm not good enough for you? Warner, I'm from Malibu. I'm not exactly trailer trash here. Oprah Winfrey is our neighbor.
Elle, if I'm gonna be a senator when I'm 30, I'm gonna need somebody serious. Less of a Marilyn, more of a Jackie. Serious. Somebody classy and not too tacky. Okay, that came out wrong. Baby, let's both be strong. I mean, we've known all along.
Just shut up. What does that mean, I'm not a Jackie? I'm not serious, but I am seriously in love with you.
Baby, my future's all planned. I've got some dreams to make true. I thought that you'd understand. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious. Check, please.
Must we all
named after you, Elle Magazine.
Thanks, Pilar, but I think it's gonna take more than Town and Country and Elle to bring me back from my shame spiral.
Well then, honey, you're just gonna have to hold on, cause the new Vogue's not out till next week.
Ah!
What?
Don't tell me ponchos are back in.
No, worse. Warner's brother, Peyton Huntington IV, and his new bride. Pictures from his wedding, look.
Muffy Vanderbilt?
Muffy.
Wait a sec. This is the kind of girl Warner wants. Someone serious. Someone lawyerly. Someone who wears black even when nobody's dead. Girls, I have a completely brilliant plan! What you want, Warner, what you want is me. But you need to see me in a brand new domain. Well, in plain, Warner, the patron said, if you would see, you're getting all of this plus a brain. I'll meet you there at Harvard with a book in my hand. Big sturdy book, big ready book.
It's like the damn frontier. Tell me what's out there that you can get right here.
Guys, love.
Love.
I'm going there for love.
Love.
A love I have to give. I can't just walk away. A train would might have been.
Fine, okay, I'll pay your way if you get in. Make the green. And it's pain.
You want to be wondering where you used to. Admission to Adam Cohen and Sandeep Padavadan.
Outstanding.
And now Miss Elle Woods.
She's applying.
Apparently. Yes, in fashion merchandising.
She got a 175 on her LSAT.
And there's a letter of recommendation from Oprah Winfrey.
Now I'm not saying Miss Woods is entirely unqualified, but look at her. Is that the face of Harvard Law?
Multiculturalism.
Excuse me?
We could admit it for reasons of multiculturalism.
Professors, get a hold of yourselves. This is Harvard Law School, not Match.com. And oh, would you look at that? What a shame. She didn't bother sending in a personal essay.
How's this for a personal essay?
You want Harvard, I'm the girl for you. And to prove it's true, we all flew here on JetBlue. Thank you!
Thank you!
This is what Elle Woods inspires. Everyone admires her, and Harvard should too.
This is not a personal essay!
No, an essay so boring and so much does not fit. So we're appearing live right here, making clear you must admit that Elle Woods should be the chosen few. Harvard puts you on it right in front of.
Don't you want to know what you said?
Class of Out 7, represent. Welcome to the hallowed halls of Harvard Law. I know firsthand how hard you've all worked to be here today, so let's go around and share a bit about yourselves.
Aaron Schultz. I want a Fulbright and the road. I read financial software code, but that's a challenge I've outgrown. How many yachts can one man own? Some say that I'm a pompous creep. Somehow I don't lose that much sleep. Why bother with false modesty? Harvard's the perfect place for me.
Pretty impressive, good to know.
Welcome to Harvard.
What's up?
Yo!
Sandeep Agrawal Padmadan. But you may call me Your Majesty. In my country, my word was law, but then I flee because of stupid coup d'etat. But here I learn, I make new friends, and soon return in bulletproof Mercedes-Benz.
Pretty impressive, good to know.
Welcome to
Eat It Hoops! I did the Peace Corps overseas, inoculating refugees and family clinics that I built myself from mud and trees. I fought to clean up their lagoons and save their rare endangered loons and led a protest march against insensitive cartoons!
Pretty impressive, good.
But now I'm on the legal track because this country's out of whack and only women have the guts to go and take it back. We'll make the government come clean and get more people voting green and really stick it to the phallocentric Harvardine!
Oh my god, I love your top. It is so fatigue chic. So, how psyched you guys? Snaps! First day of Harvard Law School! Hi, I'm Elle Woods, and this is Bruiser Woods.
Enid.
Oh my god, we both have names that start with an E!
Oh my god, we're like practically twins!
We're just going around the circle. Tell us something about yourself.
Me? Okay. So, I'm a Gemini with a double Capricorn moon, and I have a bachelor's degree from UCLA, where I was Sig Up Sweetheart, president of Delta Nu Sorority, and founded the charity Shop for Our Cause.
Huh.
Oh, and just last week at Fred Siegel, I talked Beyonce out of buying a truly heinous cable knit tube top. Whoever said tangerine is a new pink is seriously disturbed.
I did not know that.
Does anyone know where I can find Criminal Law 101 with Professor Callahan and Warner Huntington III?
Well, we're all heading there, so I'm sure someone would be happy to show you. It's in Hauser, over there, second building to the left.
Thanks.
But I don't think dogs are exactly allowed in class.
Oh, Bruiser's not a dog. Bruiser's family. I'll just leave him in my room. He'd be happier there anyways. Bruiser loves Gilmore Girls. I'll see you later, then!
I want a Fulbright and a road.
In my financial
software.
My
world.
I've been the Peace Corps overseas, inoculating refugees and family clinics that I
just wanted. Harbor's the perfect place for
your academic roster.
Right, there's that. Let's totally catch up after class.
Who is she?
My ex-girlfriend.
All that pink you're wearing, is that even legal? Pink's my signature color, so I gather.
Everyone, take your seats. Callahan should be here any second. 3 years ago, I was sitting right where you're sitting, and I'd heard the same rumors I'm sure you've heard too. Callahan's ruthless, he bathes in the blood of sheep, blah, 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 blah. What you need to know is,
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say will be used against you. Now, when you choose a law career, the moment you embark, there's a joke you're bound to hear. A lawyer is a shark. Ignore that, it's simplistic and it's dumb. Some of you will turn out sharks, just some. The rest are chum. Our topic is blood in the water. Kids, it's time you faced. Law school is a waste. Oh yes, unless you acquire a taste for blood in the water. Dark and red and raw. You're nothing until the thrill of the kill becomes your only law. Mr. Schultz, hypothetical question. Would you be willing to defend the following banker accused of fraud? Kind old grandma took her savings and she sent it off to your client, all she saved since she was born. Well, he promised to invest it, but he spent it on prostitutes and heroin and porn.
No, I wouldn't want to take that case.
Wrong! This one is a win unless you're lazy. Grandma's broke, she'll have some hack from legal aid. Put her on the stand and call her old and crazy. Your guy was free and he can get you high and late. Look for the blood in the water. Preacher Thomas Hobbes. Only spineless snobs. Don't quarrel with the morally dubious jobs. With blood in the water, your scruples are a flaw. Miss Hoops, hypothetical question. Would you be the right lawyer for the following client? Say they offer you a bundle for defending a famous hitman from the mafia elite. Seems he missed his chosen prey, killed a nun and drove away, running over three cute puppies in the street.
What, you think I wouldn't defend him just cause he's a typical man?
Oh, you lesbians think you're so tough.
What?
Oh dear, I feel my comment has offended. Hard to argue though when you're too mad to speak. Your employment will be very quickly ended once they see how your emotions make you weak. So what's my point? I run a $1 billion law firm and I hire 4 new interns every year. From this class I will select 4 young sharks whom I respect, and those 4 will have a guaranteed career. Do you follow me? So I wanna see what exactly. Let the games begin. 4 of you will win, but just those 4 with the dorsal fin. Yes, blood in the water. So bite and scratch and claw. Yes, miss.
What, Al, what?
Someone's had their morning coffee. Would you summarize the case of State of Indiana if you heard from your reading, please?
Oh, I wanted to answer the puppy question.
But I'm asking you about the assigned reading.
Okay, who assigns reading for the first day of class?
You have guts, Miss Ritz. Miss Kensington, let us say you teach a class at Harvard Law School, a position that you're justly proud about, but a girl whom you call hasn't read the case at all. Should you let it go, or?
No, I'd throw her out.
Huh. All right, then. You heard your classmate. You have just been killed. She cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, you got guts, but now they're spilled. Your blood in the water. So cut your throat, withdraw. And if you return, be ready to learn. Or is that unfair? Oh wait, I don't care. That's just how I rule in life at school. In fear and shock and awe. You're nothing until the
comma L. Listen, I was kicked out of class once first year too. It's awful, but trust me, your law career is not over.
Law career? So not the problem. Listen, I gotta get back into class with Warner. Can you help?
Yeah, come back tomorrow and make sure you've done your reading.
Okay. Excuse me, but why would you do that to another girl?
Do what?
Us girls need to stick together. We shouldn't try to look good by making each other look bad.
I didn't make you look bad. You just weren't prepared. Try picking up a law book once in a while, but a warning, they don't come with pictures.
So, I'll give you ladies a moment then.
Aren't there girls going wild somewhere without you?
Hey!
Oh, Warner, thank God you're here.
Al, I'm really sorry.
Sorry about what?
Warner, is there something you would like to share with Elle?
Do you know her?
Yeah, Elle. Vivian and I went to boarding school together, and she's my girlfriend now.
What? I'm sorry, I just hallucinated. What did you say?
He said I'm his girlfriend.
Girlfriend! Margo, Serena, Pilar, girls, what's going on?
Honey, this is a tragedy. And every tragedy needs a Greek chorus.
Greek chorus!
Al, we're here to help.
Well, we're not actually here. No. We're just in your head. Honey, what you crying at? You're not losing him too fast. Both her hair and shoes are flat. And why is she so rude? With your tears, it's no big fan here. You were meant to wear his ring. Cheer up, chin up, it's time to bring a happy attitude. Keep it positive. As you slap her to the floor, keep it positive.
Thank you.
Welcome to the Harris family. Here with Paulette, so you know you're in good hands. I'm sort of like Allstate, but for hair.
Make me a brunette.
A what? Honey, you're a genetic lotto win. All right, something else is going on here. Back up. Paulette's listening. Spill.
Okay. I'm Elle Woods, and I came all the way out here for Harvard Law School.
That's a good school.
I know, right? And I did it to follow my one true love, Warner. And now he's dating this evil preppy.
What she got that you don't got? Three boobs?
She's serious.
Seriously? She got three boobs?
No. She's a constipated polo shirt with brown hair. And apparently that's what Warner wants. So you have to make me a brunette.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions? Love. You're lost without your love. Your heart is on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just put on some tracks from this CD I bought for the store. Ooh. Isn't that relaxing? Ooh. It's called Celtic Notes! Ooh. When I'm lonely or feeling dejected, I play this, and it never fails. I pretend like I'm in Ireland with Enya and Wales. When my telephone gets disconnected or I spend every night alone, I pretend like I'm in Ireland where the Irish bagpipes drone. Smell the grass as a rainstorm has ended. People smile as they stroll past their flocks with a red-headed sailor named Brendan, and we dance without moving our arms. In a bar once I met guy Dewey, and he bought me like 14 beers, and he told me that he was from Ireland, so I lived with him 10 years. If I squinted, he looked like my sailor through my boozy delusional fog, but he dumped me for some slut named Kayla, took my trailer and took my dog. In Ireland they know how to love you. You embrace in the misty Irish breeze. And if your Irish boy tires of you, you're allowed to shoot him in the knees. Hey, you look like that poster Ireland. Long blonde hair and that sweet sunny face. Oh no, wait, that's the poster for Sweden. Oh, screw it, I'll never see either place. But a girl as sweet as you has a future. You have hope. As each new day dawns, girls like you always get to see Ireland. Give my love to the
should be denied her dog.
Tell me something I don't know.
So I'll bring the lobster pot stickers.
Perfect. And I'll bring a case of Chardonnay. Now, that's a party.
There's a party? Oh. Hello, Vivian.
Hello, Elle. Yeah, next Friday night a few of us are getting together.
Hey! Maybe that guy you like will be there. Elle, you should go.
Totally come. It's a costume party.
I love costume parties.
Of course you do. 2:43 Mass Ave, Friday. See you then.
Thanks, Vivian.
Oh, you are so borrowing my secret weapon costume I got in storage, Elle. I'll just dust off the mothballs and wait till you see it. Now you go and do this, honey, because if a girl like you can't win back your man, there's no hope for the rest of us.
Thanks for talking me off the ledge, Paulette. You have no idea how much I needed this.
Now you go and fight for him! The Irish fear nothing and no one. They keep fighting till everyone's dead. I'm not sure where this metaphor is going. I just felt like it had to be said. There's a guy at that party who loves you. Something most of us only dream of. You go out there and you get some Ireland. The country of whiskey and love.
Much for having this.
My pleasure.
We all needed a break from our law school anxieties and worrying about Callahan's internship.
Thank you. You can say that again.
No, please. Go enjoy yourselves. Mingle. Do you know that Whitney's father is next in line to be Speaker of the House?
So you've said.
Just think about it. Future presidents could be in this very room. I'm gonna ask Cole to join our study group. His summer home is 3 houses down from Justice Souter.
Great, I'm gonna go get a beer.
Hi, stranger.
Oh, man, what's with the costume?
Can a girl shake things up a bit?
Yeah, but why couldn't you have worn this when we were going out?
Because I guess you never asked.
Which will now rank as the greatest regret of my life. Elle, I still can't get over the fact that you're here at Harvard. Back at UCLA, I never would have guessed it. Sometimes, I miss the old days. Those parties senior year, I thought we ruled the world.
You funneled all that beer. I held your hair when you hurled.
We were like gods back then, walking among common men. Tell me, why can't it be that way again?
Dreams don't just disappear. We could keep on dreaming them here.
What?
Like senior year, but better. You've got the future all planned.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
What if I'm standing there too?
Wait, I'm not following you.
I'm here 'cause I'm serious.
Yeah, right. You look real serious.
Warner, don't forget I got into this school too. And now we're both here studying law together. Maybe we'll both get Callahan's internship and work together.
Whoa. Wait a second. Elle, you get kicked out of class like every single day. You don't actually believe you have a chance of getting that internship. Everybody in the class wants it. Nobody more than me. It's a guaranteed career. You're practically made partner before you even get a job offer.
Elle, you looking fluffy this evening.
Hello, Vivian. Thanks for the great tip on the costume party. I see you came at last year's sample sale.
Hubert, Elle, you have to ace his course to get that internship, and he's not called C-minus Callahan for nothing.
Warner, I'm completely cognizant of both of those facts.
You're not going to make it through the rest of the semester, let alone get Callahan's internship. Even if you keep on going and going and going. Face it, Bunny, one of these things is not like the other. Someday we'll nominate Supreme Court justices and you'll tan. Run home, Elle, and change out of your skank costume.
Oh, is that what you see, Vivian? How unfortunate, because I am Gloria Steinem, undercover, circa 1963, researching for her feminist manifesto, I was a Playboy Bunny. Are you really calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
Who's calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
She is.
Whoa. What's up? Doc?
Love.
Excuse me?
I put my faith in love. I followed where it led.
Love led you here.
To my personal circle of hell. It has not worked out well. I wish that I were dead. Cause instead of a wedding and love, I'm walking out of school, a total laughing stock. Someone he and his friends can just mock. So go on, here's my head. Just hit it with a rock.
Wait, go back. You came out here to follow a man. Harvard Law was just part of that plan. Man, what rich romantic planet are you from?
Malibu?
Instead of lying outside by the pool, you stalked some guy to an Ivy League school. That's the weirdest reason I...
Well, why'd you come?
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums. Guys, you showed me all the ways a man can fail. I got through law school by busting my ass. Worked two jobs in addition to class. So forgive me for not weeping at your tail.
Excuse me, just because you've got some kind of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There's a chip on my shoulder, and it's big as a boulder. But with the chance I've been given, I'm gonna be driven as hell. Though I can't take the day off, I just think of the payoff. You need a chip on your shoulder, you might wanna get one as well.
I'm sorry, but that sounds highly negative.
Hey, I'm just being honest. When you weren't born into privilege, you've gotta work twice as hard. And I want my sweatshirt back.
Wait, two jobs plus law school?
I haven't slept since 1998.
Seriously, how'd you do it?
Well, I don't go to parties a lot. Not good use of the time that I've got. Can't spend hours doing my hair or staying in shape.
I don't spend hours.
But I know it'll all be worthwhile when I win my first lucrative trial and buy my mom that great big house out on the Cape.
Oh, that's so sweet.
No, that's the chip on my shoulder. I hugged my mom and told her, but with the chance I've been given, I'm gonna be driven as hell. Though I can't take the day off, I just think of the payoff. You need a chip on your shoulder. You might wanna get one as well.
I just need to prove to everyone that I'm serious.
What you need is to get to work.
Make yourself at home.
Hello, Kitty. You drink a lot of Red Bull, don't you?
What?
So you can...
She gives me energy!
So you can stay up late studying?
What?
I said studying! You do study, don't you? Where are all those law books?
They're under the...
Under the...
Under the pile of... somewhere on the... Right
on the...
Maybe under the... There! Oh, they're here somewhere.
You know, this vanity's real picturesque, but it started its life as a desk. Throw it off and find some room for books instead.
Hey, what are you doing?
Can you live without this? Can you live without that? I don't know what this is.
It's for hair.
Wear a hat. Spend some time improving what's inside your head. out, out. Put it in storage, sell it on eBay, leave it behind. Out, out. What, are you angry? Good, so get angry. You may find a chip on your shoulder. Your room just got colder. But with the chance you've been given, why you not driven as hell? There's no way around it. Gotta plow through till you
found it.
Been reading it hard, I can tell.
Tis a gift to be simple, tis a gift to be free.
What is this? My second or third? Anyway, I love it. Define malum prohibitum.
Malum prohibitum is...
Is an act
prohibited by law, jaywalking or chewing gum in Singapore.
Therefore, malum in se...
Malum in se is an action, evil in itself. Assault, murder, white shoes after Labor Day.
Good. Where are you going?
Home, of course. It's Thanksgiving break, remember?
Interesting. I predict you will probably pass in the bottom percent of your class.
What?
If you're going for mediocre, you've done great.
That's not fair.
Look, they laughed at me like they're laughing at you. You can't win if we don't follow through. Might I venture your vacation plans can wait? Going home for Christmas, but...
You are so sweet.
It's a real time saver. It's shampoo and conditioner in one.
Hair care. I love this guy. So I'll just leave you to the one then. Bye bye.
You are too adorable to think of me.
Elle, hey, have you seen Viv? I've been looking everywhere for her.
Yeah.
I mean, no.
Great, we're gonna miss our flight.
Elle? I don't know if you noticed before, but each time Warner walks through the door, your IQ goes down to 40. Maybe less. Though it's hardly my business to say, could it be the real thing in your way is the very guy you're trying to impress?
Yes! I've been smiling and sweet and thoroughly beaten, blowing my chance. Let's not chase him away. Let's face him and say, hey, punk, let's dance. This chip on my shoulder makes me smarter and bolder. No more whining or claiming, I'm reclaiming my pride. Grab that book and let's do this. Instead of drilling hard, don't do this. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder. Let's see him knock it aside.
Rights to ask for visitation, Russell B. Sullivan.
But Russell wasn't known to the mother. Latimer was an anonymous donor.
Yeah, but without Mr. Latimer's sperm, the child in question wouldn't exist.
Now, you're thinking like a lawyer. Yes, Miss Woods.
Mr. Huntington makes an excellent point, but did the defendant keep a log of every sperm emission he made throughout his life?
Interesting. Why do you ask?
Well, unless the defendant attempted to contact every sexual encounter he had to see if a child resulted from those unions, he has no parental claim over this child whatsoever. Why now?
Why this sperm?
I see your point.
And by Mr. Huntington's standards, all masturbatory emissions where the sperm was clearly not seeking an egg could be called reckless abandonment.
Miss Woods, you've just won your case.
Oh my
God. Wait, hold on, we just won the case. Oh my God. And all of you water space.
Oh my God.
Miss Woods, excellent work today. I'm assuming you're applying for my internship. Do you have a resume?
I am one step ahead of you. Here you go. And thanks in advance for your consideration.
Oh God, it's scented. 3 months ago, I would have recycled this. Make sure you put it on file.
Guess she got a chip on her shoulder. Maybe some wise man told her. But with the chance we've been given, we gotta be driven as hell. She was something to see there. I'm just happy I can be there. For the big test that she aced it. She's so close she can taste it. She got a chip on her shoulder. Guess you never can tell.
Bakes her dog a birthday cake deserves nothing less.
It is shaped like a bone.
And that sort of devotion cannot be ignored.
It's not easy finding dog-friendly chocolate substitutes.
Crap. Not you again. Paulette, get your fat ass off of my property.
I want to see my dog, Dewey. I bet you didn't even know it was his birthday today.
Oh, it's your birthday. It's your birthday. Well, you can't see him, Jellygut. Best decision I ever made, throwing you out.
Can you believe I lived with that for 10 years? That cheapskate never even got me a ring.
Oh, they lived together for 10 years?
Of course, Emmett, you're a genius.
Now what?
Mr. Dewey. We are Ms. Bonafonte's legal team.
Lawyers?
Mm-hmm. I don't think you understand that the great Commonwealth of Massachusetts recognizes your 10-year relationship with Ms. Bonafonte as a common law marriage, which entitles her to equitable division of property.
Huh?
Translation?
We're taking the dog!
Whatever.
Anybody's ever done for me, bar none.
Wait, was that law? Is this the point of law? I'm feeling kind of high.
You okay?
This is why we all study and slog to help the underdog. So identify.
Guys! Callahan just got a big murder trial defending exercise queen Brooke Wyndham. He just posted his internship.
Ladies and gentlemen, I need the best and the brightest. Congrats to the choice of few, and for the rest of you, welcome to the middle. Emmett, I am making you co-counsel for the Wyndham trial. Prove yourself here. And the term, associate, isn't far off.
Yes, sir.
We start Monday, 9 a.m., sharp! Make sure everyone dresses appropriately.
Emmett, that's so great. I'm so proud of you.
Yes, score!
Warner, we got the internship.
What?
It's just like we planned.
Babe, this is just the beginning. This is perfect. Make this the happiest day of my life.
Warner, it's absolutely stunning.
Marry me?
Yes.
All of this time I planned I'd be patient and would love me again. You'd come to respect my mind, and at last you'd find you could love me again. And I have turned my whole world upside down, trying not to let you go. Watching you walk away is like a fatal blow. What?
Whoa!
Is that my name up on that list? Does someone know that I exist? Is this a mistake? Or am I even awake? Can she now do it? Love with you.
work is off right now. My workout's not for you. I'm talking to the woman who wants it all. Gotta pay for what you get. Side too close, don't come too. Don't be lazy to sweat. I want you with the in shape. When I say jump, say how high. You know you're doing it right. When you start to cry, if you don't look like you should, you got to whip it, whip it, whip it good. Sorry, ladies, no escape till you're whipped into shape. Come on, Dana, you slacker, work it out.
I think you broke.
We have a lot to cover. Meet our brand new client, Brooke. You can laugh, but she's made tons off her DVDs and books. Whip your way to tighter buns. Happily married, so she swears, to her 60-year-old stud, till stepdaughter came downstairs and found Brooke all covered in his blood. If Brooke took a plea, I'd have her out in 3 to 4. But she claims she did not kill him. Let's watch some more.
But it's more than just a workout, it's a defensive weapon too. Simply wrap it around your assailant's neck, then pull till he turns blue. You can also use the patented handle grips to shatter your attacker's spine. And all for 3 small payments of $19.99. You'll have him within his shape when you free from a guy. Just work him over with this till he starts to cry. He don't act like he should. You got to whip it, whip it, whip it good.
Think she's guilty. Here is where you kids come in. Brooke has trouble trusting me. I'm her only chance to win, but I don't speak MTV. But Brooke won't help her on defense. She may listen to her peers. Go and place a little sense in the space between her ears. Not now. I want her whipped into shape. If there's a brain in that hair, tell it that I am the key. It's the plea or the chair. See, when I talk to her, I get neither plea nor plan nor alibi to quote from our defendant's tape. I want her whipped into shape. To the jail. Eat it.
Come on, ladies. Just because we're in Boston Women's Correctional Facility doesn't mean we can't become the best that we can be. Circle, circle, under, over, through, around. 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 Left, right. Left.
Emmett Forrest. I'm co-counsel with Stidwell, Zyzowski, Fox, and Callahan. These 4 interns are the cream of the crop at Harvard Law, and we're here to whip up your legal defense. Incidentally, my mom's a big fan of your DVDs. Credit to you with her nutcracker butt. Her words. Anywho, we'd love to discuss your case and go over a few choices. We want to free you as soon as possible so you can get your message back to your fans.
That's all I want. This should be easy.
Okay, great. Callahan briefed me on your meeting, and there is a significant amount of evidence against you. To free you, the jury will need to hear an alibi.
Not gonna happen.
Even if it could free you?
Yep. Put me on that stand and I'll be forced to lie.
Okay, Ms. Windham, if we can't hear an alibi, you should at least accept a plea bargain.
And admit to something I didn't do?
But a plea bargain can get you out in just a few years. Sounds pretty reasonable, right?
Reasonable to do time for my husband's killer. Not really.
Ooh, she's tough.
Yo, sister!
Yo! Not related. I need a defense team who knows I'm innocent. Get out of here, all of you! Guard?
Stop being a Marilyn, L. Callahan wants that alibi. Give it to him and you can sail through law school knowing that there is a big fat job offer waiting for you when you get out.
But I gave Brooke my word.
So what? Who cares?
Who cares?
Emmett, let me be very clear. This is your chance and I gave you simple instructions. Leave the legal team and get me an alibi. You're 0 for 2. Everyone, field trip is over. Let's get back to work. Ah, except for you two. I would rather not see a ratty corduroy or a legally blonde again today.
Emmett, I'm sorry.
I don't need you to be sorry. I need you to tell me the alibi.
I can't because I gave Brooke my word. Having an alibi is not the only way to win this case.
No, but it sure would help.
Work with me. Help me free Brooke the right way. The noble way.
This isn't a Lifetime original movie, Elle. I'm not interested in nobility right now. I'm interested in saving Brooke's life.
No, you're not. You're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, he is my boss. And if I do a good job, he'll make me associate.
And risk your client's trust and our integrity?
Well, when you put it that way.
Exactly, Butthead. My word means something, and I know yours does too.
Nobody's called me Butthead since third grade.
Maybe not to your face. Come on, let's get out of here.
Why do you always have to be right?
I don't have to be. When I'm with you, I just am. Hey, if you wanna help, you know, impress Callahan,
something out.
Okay, how?
Listen, I love your scruffy vibe, but casual Friday is so not in Callahan's vocabulary.
Elle, didn't your mother ever teach you not to judge a book by its cover?
She did. And books with tattered covers stay on the shelf.
Thanks a lot.
Emmett, this is an imperfect world. I haven't been judged my whole life. Think it wasn't a smart idea to make Navy my new pink?
No, it was a good idea.
I know.
Where are we going exactly?
You trust me, don't you?
Yes.
Then don't stop now.
What is this place?
Nordstrom's.
It's beautiful.
Here's your chance to make it.
So take it now.
So take it. There! Now you're ready for your big trial. You sure you don't want me to paint little gavels on them for you?
No, it's okay, Paulette. I think that might be a bit too much.
Classy lawyer think it is. When those jury people see those nails, they'll know they can trust you.
Which is more than I can say for my team. They're all over me to give up Brooke's alibi.
Including your friend, Emmett.
Well, he is on the team, too.
Yeah, in more ways than one, I see the way he looks at you.
Paulette, he's just a friend.
Right, and I could use a friend like that.
I've got a package for Miss Paulette Buonafonte. The name's Kyle. This is my new route and the first stop of the day. Kinda cool karma, huh? Alrighty then. Do me a favor. You have yourself a super day.
God, the new UPS guy's like walking porn.
So talk to him already.
Right. I'm not like you. I've got nothing to offer. Oh my God.
Did you see that?
She's got the most perfect Bennett snap I've ever seen.
You're a natural.
Hi, Paulette. I see dead people.
Oh, this is just my Greek chorus. I'm so psyched you can see them too now.
But I haven't had any Jaeger.
When your head of snap has that much snap, it's been known to alter all laws of physics and logic.
What are you talking about, Bendy Snap?
The bed. It's a move invented by UCLA cheerleaders to break the will of the opposing team. But it also has real-world applications, too. The bend and snap is 99.99% effective on straight men.
Right, and I have a great track record with those.
I see the problem here. And it's not physical.
No, it's spiritual.
Paulette just needs a little spirit.
And Serena knows about spirit because she's a UCLA cheer team leader.
Go! Help
me!
Paulette, do you know why cheerleaders get the guy and keep the guy?
Because you jump around and show your panties?
Yeah. But also because cheerleaders command and demand attention. Got the pom-poms. Time to shake them! Ready? Okay. Look at my ass, look at my thighs. I'm patting a few guys, they chase my tail, they blew in pants. Wanna touch us, but they can't. No! All boys wanna come and play. Send my fingers and they okay. Why do they follow me around all day? Watch me while I walk away from my bed. Yeah. Feel the hottest kick. Yeah. And when you've done the sweat,
selling.
Will you pay for stuff I buy?
Yes.
And bake me cake and pie?
Yes.
And hold me when I cry?
Yes.
I will tell you why.
Why?
I'm too rough to
lock away.
All the boys do
dock away.
Drop the jobs to
block away.
Walking as I walk away.
Watch her walk away.
I'm
filters.
Unbelievable. You're all making me look like an ass up there. Your Honor, I request a 10-minute recess.
Sorry, I'll take this outside.
Why didn't I know about this disaster?
All right, it is a setback,
it's
but...
It's motive, Emmett.
Hey, Paulette, what's up?
Hi, Elle. I just had to call and thank you. The vengeance snap really worked. I may have broken Kyle's nose, but I got to spend 4.5 hours with him in the ambulance and in the ER. It was the most romantic time in my whole life.
Oh, Paula, that's great. I told you that Ben and Snap is infallible, unless the guy is gay or something. Oh my God, I gotta go, bye.
Bye.
Maybe you should do it one more time.
Please!
Nichols couldn't have had the affair with Brooke. I just did the pen and snap in front of him and nothing. Clearly the guy must be gay.
Nichols did leave a share CD in the pool house once.
You want to out this guy on the stand, Elle? That's crazy. You can't build a legal strategy on the bended snap. We need a defense, not a dance move.
So you think he's perjured himself, but you can't prove it. If you're wrong, we look desperate and homophobic.
But if she's right,
and I know I am, there, right there, the
Look at that tan, well-tended skin. Look at that killer shape he's in. Look at that slightly stubbly chin. Oh, please, he's gay. Totally gay.
Not about to celebrate. Every trait could indicate totally straight expatriate. This guy's not gay. I say not gay.
That is the elephant in the room. Well, it's irrelevant to assume that a man who wears perfume is automatically radically fake.
Look at his clumped and crispy locks.
Look at his silk translucent socks.
There's eternal paradox. Look what we're seeing.
What are we seeing?
Is he gay or European?
Look at me.
You see, they bring their voice up different in those charming foreign ports. They play peculiar sports
in tiny shirts and tiny shorts.
Gay
foreign fella, the answer to tingling. They will say things like "Ciao bella" while they kiss you on the cheek.
Oh, please, gay
European. So many shades of gray.
Depending on the time of day, the French go either way.
Gay or European, or
they're right there. Look at that condescending smirk. Seen it on every guy at work. That is a macho, macho jerk. That guy's not gay. I say no way.
That is the elephant in the room. What is it relevant to presume that a hottie in that costume
is automatically, radically,
ironically,
genetically, medically gay,
officially gay, officially gay, 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 gay. Damn it! Gay or European?
This is why you should relax.
Is he gay or European?
Wow. You see, they bring their voice up different. There is culturally diverse. It's not a fashion curse
if he wears a kilt or bears a purse.
Gay or just
exotic,
I still can't crack the code. Yes, his accent is hypnotic, but his shoes are pointy-toed.
Huh, gay or European, so many shades of gray.
And if he turns out straight, I'm free at 8 on Saturday.
Is he gay or European? Gay or European? Gay or European?
Wait a minute! Give me a chance to crack this guy. I have an idea I'd like to try. The floor is yours. So, Mr. Argitacos, this alleged affair with Miss Wyndham has been going on for?
2 years.
And your first name is again?
Nikos.
And your boyfriend's name is?
Carlos. Oh, I'm sorry, I misunderstood. You said a boyfriend, I thought you said a best friend. Carlos is my best friend.
You bastard! You lying bastard! That is it! I come out for you, no more! Because I have a big announcement! This man is gay! Ah, European! That is the thing! You have to stop your being! What he said, I swear he never, ever, ever swing me either way. You are so gay, you big parfait, you want that flaming cabaret.
I'm straight!
You were not yesterday. So if I may, I'm proud to say, he's gay! He's gay! He's gay!
I'm okay, I'm gay! Turning the case around and nailing the pool boy.
Ha! Emmett nailed the pool boy!
You nailed the
Well,
I have to share this victory with Elle.
To Emmett. And I can't believe I'm saying this, but... To Elle.
To Elle.
Yeah, but since when does a finely tuned Gaydar count as a legal victory?
But without that Gaydar, we wouldn't be celebrating with champagne. We'd be dead in the waters. Elwood's trusted her gut and has shown more legal smart than most of my staff. She won this round, making her a good lawyer. And although we would still like to hear the alibi she got, by keeping it, she never compromised her client's trust, making her a great one. That is more than what I can say about you, Warner. Be useful. Go get me a cup of coffee.
But we're drinking champagne.
Splenda and Skim. Everyone else, go back home and get a good night's sleep. I need you all sharp tomorrow morning. Miss Woods, could I have a word?
Of course. I'll catch up with you in a second. And thank you for what you said before. It meant a lot.
You deserved it. But don't tell the other law students I said so. I have a scary reputation to uphold.
Your secret's safe with me. But I really do appreciate this opportunity to work with you. I've learned so much.
What you've learned isn't the point. You have instincts, and instincts, legal or otherwise, can't be taught. Trust your instincts. I thought you were smarter than that.
Is that the only reason you gave me this internship?
It was nice working with you, Miss Woods. You can show yourself out!
Well, hello, Marilyn. Looks like you'll make partner now. You've really earned it.
Warner, shut up. Take back the books and pack up the clothes. Clear out the room and drop off the key. Leave with what's left of my dignity. Get in the car and just go. Chalk it all up to experience. They said I'd fail, but I disagreed. Who could say then where my path would lead? Well, now I know. Back to the sun. Back to the shore, back to what I was before. Back where I'm known, back in my own very small pond. Laugh with my friends when I arrive. We'll drop the top and just
she is, intern of the year.
Thanks for your help and for all you've done. Thank you for treating me decent.
What's wrong?
Maybe someday you can visit me. Give me a call, say hello.
Wait, where are you going?
Sorry, I'm heading down everywhere.
Brought on this.
You did your best with a holder's kiss.
That's ludicrous.
You are the best thing about this place.
Oh, you should know.
Callahan hit on me.
He what?
He kissed me. He fired me. He made it very clear I don't belong.
He's wrong. We'll fix it. We'll fight it.
Emmett, please. There's no reason for me to stay.
What about love? I never mentioned love. The timing's bad, I know. But perhaps if I made it more clear that you belong right here, you wouldn't have to go. Cause you know that I'm so much in love.
Back to the sun, back to the shore, back to what I was before.
Please won't you open the door?
Lie on the beach.
Don't know we're so much more.
can I just say how much I want you to stay?
It's not up to me. Just let me be legally blind.
I need you to stay.
It's not up to me. Just let me be legally blind.
A thank you for staying with me at the hospital.
Trust me, the pleasure was all mine.
Well, I should be getting back to my route now. Duty calls.
Duty calls! All that, and he has a job.
Paulette, I just came to say goodbye.
What? Goodbye?
Yeah, I'm going back home to California.
California? Why?
Going back to where I make sense.
Honey, you're not making any sense right now. What happened?
All this time, I thought I was proving myself and making a difference, but it turns out I'm just one big blind joke. And that's all anyone's ever gonna see.
That's not what I see. Vivian. Us girls need to stick together. Maybe Warner saw a girl who was sleeping her way to the top, but I see a woman who doesn't have to.
I used to pray for the daily, swore up and down you did not belong. But when I'm wrong, then I say I'm wrong, and I'm wrong about you. So listen up, I see no end to what you'll achieve. That's only if you don't turn and run. Prove it to me now, show everyone.
Honey, you're in the supply closet.
I said I'm never wearing it again. I'm wearing this.
Legally blind.
stand for?
Brendan.
A defendant in criminal proceedings.
Only if she has a licensed attorney to supervise her.
Without me, she does not.
Yes, she does. I'm licensed, Your Honor. I'll gladly supervise.
Like hell you will. You work for me, remember?
No, I work for myself. And I don't have to hit on interns, Professor.
Swindon, enjoy prison.
Okay, bye.
Thank you, Emmett.
Did you think I was actually just gonna let you get away?
Miss Woods, any day now, you may proceed. Call your first witness.
We call Chudney Wyndham to the stand.
Oh my God.
TTP, total tragic perm.
Miss Wyndham, what was your relationship to the defendant?
He was my father.
And did you actually see his murder take place?
No, I was in the shower. But when I got out, I saw Brooke standing over my father's body, drenched in his blood.
Oh boy, we're screwed.
Don't listen to Mal. You're fine. Go ahead.
Miss Wyndham, did you happen to see anyone suspicious hanging around on the day of the murder?
Suspiciously hanging around my shower?
No, before that.
No. I was out getting a perm.
And then you came home and took a shower.
Yes. I was in the shower.
Your Honor, I would like to go to the bathroom.
Shouldn't you have gone before the murder trial?
No, I would like everyone to go to the bathroom.
Why do girls always do that?
I mean, I would like us all to go back to the bathroom where this alleged shower took place.
I'll allow it, Miss Woods.
Road trip! Road trip! Road trip! She doesn't cry, but I hope she's not
teacher please read that back?
Okay.
No, before that.
Next, I was in the shower.
Miss Windham, you claim on the day of the shower you were out getting a perm. Now, was this your first perm?
No, I've permed my hair since junior high. About 3 a year.
Interesting. My associate has just gone to perm herself today. Exhibit B, Miss Enid Hoops. Thank you, Miss Bonafonte. Now, Miss Windham, would Exhibit B's perm be similar to your own?
Duh.
And now, one more time. You didn't hear the gunshot or see the murder because you were where?
In the shower!
Thank you. Miss Hoops, would you please step into the shower?
For 48 hours.
Exactly! Water deactivates the perm's ammonium thioglycolate and completely ruins it. It's the cardinal rule of perm maintenance. You couldn't have showered that day because your curls are still intact. Why would you lie about being in the shower? Why would you lie about not hearing the gunshot? Why would you
think I liked being older than my dad's new arm candy wife? I didn't mean to hurt my father! I didn't mean to shoot him! I thought it was Brooke coming through the door!
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God!
Oh my God.
Oh my, oh my God!
Oh my God!
Hold on! Bad enough that I'm in a John. Take her into custody. You're free. And we apologize.
Oh my God, it's a dream come true.
Together. You showed me who we could be. Together again.
Oh, Warner. Vivian dumped you, didn't she? Though I dreamed of this day long ago, now my answer is thank you, but no. Look, I've barely begun, I'm hardly through. I was living in ignorant bliss, till I learned I could be more than this. And you know, in a way, I owe it all to you. I thought losing your love was a blow I could never withstand. But look how far I have come without anyone holding my hand. Find my way. You broke my heart. You handed me the chance to make a brand new start. You helped me find my way. There's still so much to learn, so many dreams to earn. And even if I crash and burn 10 times a day, I think I'm here. I'm gonna find my way.
there once rode, to thine own self be true, and it must follow as the night the day. Thou canst not then be false to any man. I believe this wise statement best applies to a woman, a blonde woman. The past 3 years she showed me and all of us that being true to yourself never goes out of style. Ladies and gentlemen, your valedictorian, Elle Woods.
Congratulations to the class of 2000.
Here's the part where she gives her big speech. We're so proud, but I was not one to preach. So she said we could play, where are they now? Here we go. Enid practices family law. Vivian's training for the Peace Corps. Warner quits as he makes more modeling anyhow. Callahan ran for governor, but was defeated, of course. And his wife hired Emmett to handle their messy divorce. And me, well, I think I'll find my way. And hey, I'm Mary Kyle. And now we have two kids. And one more on the way. And we live out in Worcester. I bought a new salon. It also features dog grooming. Here, take a couple cards. Oops, sorry. Back to Elle.
I thank you one and all, the ones who thought I'd fall, who taught me how to fail, who helped me to prevail. I'm standing here today. Happiest woman I know.
Thank you.
Thank you.